Next is brow center. The center located in eyebrow region. Listen. Yesterday we worked on mamakara. So far we have worked on both mamakara and anyakara. Did you observe? We were too busy with mamakara and anyakara. We did not work on ahankara. Now we are going to work on ahankara. The relationship you share with both your mamakara and ahamkara is directly connected to your brow center. When you have non-integrated and inauthentic relationship between mamakara and ahamkara, for example, in mamakara you feel you are covered, frightened, no courage. And in ahankara you show courageous, powerful, direct inauthentic, direct non-integrated. Then your agnya collapses. Having integrity and authenticity with mamakara and ahankara, your agnya flowers. Unfortunately, almost all human beings have inauthenticity with both mamakara and ahankara. How many of you feel you have inauthenticity with your ahankara and mamakara? I think I should ask in the other way. How many of you feel you don't have inauthenticity? No, you cannot be. If you have, come on, I have a place for you here. This whole second row you can fill. Or I'll even empty this. Lion, you sit there. This seat is not that comfortable seat, understand? How many of you are greedy of this seat? Lot of responsibility, understand? Huge responsibility. Even the snake, when it bites you, it will tell, you gave me the poison, what can I do? I can vomit this only to your feet. You give me nectar, I will vomit nectar. The Kalinga, that snake, tells Krishna, after trying to kill Krishna, this fellow tells, I vomited poison true, but you gave me that only. Means, for everything you became responsible. Listen. Inside you, you always believe yourself lower than what you are. And outside you, you always project yourself higher than what you are. How many of you are able to cognize this? Agnya, brow center collapses when your ahankara and mamakara is not aligned, whenever there is a mismatch in what you believe as you inside and what you project as you outside. It is like a sharp sword having both sides rubbing you constantly. When there is an inauthenticity between your mamakara and ahankara, both sides it is painful. Do you see? Inside also it is painful. Outside what you project because nobody believes it, it is painful. How many of you are very clear that whatever you project, people are not believing? Raise your hand. It's very painful, do you know? You project something so sincerely, seriously, almost like a 10 days you work hard and make a beautiful flower, arts. Suddenly somebody comes and tells, fool, all these flowers have withered away 10 days before, you did not see up. You are arranging, so busy in arranging. By the 10 days you came to the lower part and you say, wow, I have done a flower arch. Somebody comes and knocks at you the back and says, see up. 1 week before it all withered away. Only then you say, oh God, what I try to project is not happening. It hurts. It hurts. The inauthenticity of your ahamkara is pulling you down, and making you feel shrink. Your life only has two way: one, egoing, or easy going. If it is not aligned, your mamakara and ahankara, it is egoing. If both of them are aligned, it is easy going. You can see when someone is egoistic, they become very heavy, serious, start living with disease. I think if you do the process, you will be able to have deeper insights.
When you expose your mamakara to the world, you lose effectiveness with people.
No, I am not saying you expose. All I am saying is align. See, what your ahankara you project. Internalize that itself and make it as mamakara. That's all.
So whatever
I am not saying project mamakara to ahankara. Project ahankara to mamakara.
Oh, whatever I project there, I just believe myself.
Yes.
Okay. That is easy.
Listen, listen. Scan your whole life and identify the specific aspects of your ahankara which leaves you with conflicting experience with others in your life. That is, identify areas of your life where you feel powerless or experience conflict with others because of the thoughts and words you have uttered and the perception about yourself that you have projected to others, which is not aligned with what you experience as you inside you. For example, you have projected an image to your boss that you are very efficient, and deep within you project an image to yourself that you are a failure. So your efficiency is not showing up in your work and your boss is not happy with you. This may leave you with a conflicting experience in your relationship with your boss. This is an example. Understand, whenever you feel powerless or experience conflict in your life, there is surely some inauthenticity in that aspect of your life. Second, look deeply within and identify the inauthenticity in those conflicting aspects of you that you project to others as you. Identify the words you utter about yourself to others which are not according to the peak of your capacity. That is, what do you think of as your peak capacity and what do you project to others as the peak of your capacity? Identify the words you utter to those, to others, about yourself which you did not honor and fulfill. Now restore integrity and authenticity in those aspects of your life, complete with others who are involved in the respective conflicting situations in your life. Actually, this fourth and fifth is you are supposed to be doing in the house. First three only you are supposed to write answer. Fifth is now with integrity and authenticity, give a new word to others about yourself. Give a new commitment to others which is aligned with the peak of your capacity. That's what you think of as your peak capacity, what others think of as your peak capacity, and declare that you will now do anything and everything to honor and fulfill it.